first. Let's pay homage to the Venerable Monk Liao Ming. Homage to Master Sakya Zenkong. Homage to the 16 Dharma King Kamapa. And homage to Master Dukten Dorji. Homage to the three jewels of the altar. Homage to the main deity of Homa today. Namo Mahottara Heruka. And the 100 deities, 100 serene and wrathful deities, and the three celestial maidens. And all the deities that descended. Vishnu, Garuda, Shiva, and Ganesh, and the great Brahma. Sumo.
Tuten Siddhi Rinpoche.
Tuten Siddhi Rinpoche.
Tanzen Gacho.
Tanzen Gacho Rinpoche.
Rinpoche.
And all Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma lecturers, Dharma assistants, temple directors, and all disciples present here and over the internet. And the participating VIPs today is the Secretary General for CCNAA of Republic of Taiwan, Ambassador Daniel and Mrs. Liao. And the Secretary to the Taiwan Provincial Government, Mr. and Mrs. Cheng. Dr. Ryan Zhuang. The President to the Sun Yan Lu Foundation, Dr. Lu Fuqing. And the Director to the Sun Yan Lu Foundation, Mr. Lu and Mrs. Lu Fuqi and Mrs. Lu, Sunny Lu. And the Treasurer to the Sun Yan Lu Foundation.
A-N-D-Y-R-O-V-E-R-P.
And the director to the Sun Yan Lu Foundation, Miss Teresa and Larry Pearson, academician from Academia Sinica, Professor and Mrs. Zhu. From Chinese Hong Kong University of the Culture and Religion Department, Professor Tham. from National Tsenggong University EE Department, Professor Wang Di. From the scholars, a group of Tubuda School, Professor Liang Caofan, advising attorney to the Tubuda Foundation, Dharma Sister Jennifer Zhou, the advising attorney to the Tubuda Foundation, Ms. Luo, and the advising attorney to the Tubuda Foundation, Ms. Ng. President of the Lotus Light Charity Society, Worldwide Lotus Light Charity Society, Master Chang Ren, producer for the Great Perfection Dharma Dok Chen, Hevajra, Master Lian Yue, and Hevajra Exposition. A well-known photographer from England, Dharma Brother Tony Chow, President of the U.S. Natron Company, Ms. Winnie Che, Dr. Zhou Heng, and Dr. Lin Shuhua, and the pharmacist Xi Hongchun and family. And the PR director of Taiwan Leizang Temple, Mr. Fermi Wang. From CTI-TV, Taiwan producers for Geni Dianshang Xinten, Dharma Sister Rebecca Xiaqi. And Professor You Jiangcheng. And Professor Ye Shuwen. And Professor Lin Xiangji from Yilan University. And Professor Chen. And from Sao Paulo, Brazil, Professor Chen and Dr. Chen, also a Chinese department professor from Sao Paulo, Brazil University, Dr. Chen. And also the vice principal to the Cultural Center of the Language School in Brazil, Ms. Liang. And also from Brazil, Ms. Zhou, President of the Lotus Light Charity Society of Taiwan, Mr. Li Chunyang, Ms. Vivian Shi. And a TV host and also an actor from Singapore, Dharma Sister Yiling. And many more who have not been registered or introduced, we all would like to welcome. We would like to welcome them all. From a businessman from Indonesia, Mr. and Mrs. Arjun Chen, good afternoon, everyone. 这个要按，不要按到。9月20号。 Next Sunday is September 20th at 3 p.m. There will be the Adi Buddha Homa fire offering ceremony starting at 3 p.m. And Adi Buddha is the primordial Buddha, which is the original Buddha and Buddha of the 16th ground. The 13th ground Buddha is Vairocana Buddha and the five Dhyani Buddhas are from the 13th ground. But Adi Buddha is from the 16th ground, Samantabhadra. And very few people would perform a ceremony of this deity. So the primordial Buddha, Adi Buddha, the Samantabhadra Tathagata are the epithets or the names of the same deity. And also Dorje Chang or Vajradhara are also one of his names. They are all his names. So whether you want to become primary supplicants or not, it is up to you. I don't have opinions either way. It is the greatest Buddha. It's fine if you don't want to become primary supplicants because it's not easy to become the greatest. Well, it would be best if no one become the primary supplicants. And today, the Mahottara Heruka, let me tell you that he is the emanation, the wrathful emanation of the greatest Adi Buddha, and that is Mahottara Heruka. And there are so many primary supplicants for this deity today. I don't know how many people there were. That the Hatha offering took about 50 minutes. That his origin was the Adi Buddha. And Mahottara Heruka was the wrathful emanation. And his primary supplicants already took 50 minutes. So would you want to embarrass Adi Buddha? Then you don't need to become the primary supplicants for Adi Buddha. That the Adi Buddha and Mahottara are together, and they are truly precious. And I asked Master Lien Yin about the mantra, the president of the Rainbow Temple of Rainbow Vela, who composed this mantra chanting. And then Yin said, we did. I said, really? Rainbow Temple could do such a good mantra chanting? Then in the future, all mantra chanting should be this great. Then that would be incredible. Where is Master Lien Yin? Congratulations. Was this composed by Rainbow Temple? It is from Zhongguan Chapter, Master Lien
Yue.
But you are the president of Rainbow Temple, and you don't even know who made the mantra chanting.
Oh,
So the mantra chanting was wonderful. And then you added that, added the drums. So the baseball was hit by the Zhongguan chapter, but you just blow a breath. But the baseball was going to be home run, already home run, and yet you just blow a little bit of wind. So you still have some credit. But let me recite the piece of the writing that Mahavatara Heruka was manifested by the Adi Buddha, and his appearance has 21 faces, 42 arms, and 8 legs, and each of the hands is holding a mirror. Inside it, 42 serene deities, including the Adi Buddha, Samantabhadra and Samantabhadri, the 5 dimensional Buddhas, the 5 Buddha Mother, the 8 Bodhisattvas, the 8 female Bodhisattvas, and the 4 Ragarajas, and the 4 wrathful Buddha Mother, and the 6 Munis. And the Buddha Mother has 9 faces, 18 arms, and 4 legs, and each of the hands holding a mirror. And then there are 2 hands that's holding a carved knife and a kapala, and the rest are holding mirrors, appearing very wrathful. So, for this Mahavatara Heruka, the deities that descended earlier, there were 100. So Mahavatara Heruka, the 100 serene and wrathful deities, and the 3 celestial maidens from yesterday's ceremony, and the Hindu gods that include Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. They all descended. So they have tremendous majestic power and boundless power. So in the merit dedication, that I pray that all the wishes that you have in your hearts can be fulfilled. And I also pray to Mahavatara Heruka and all the deities to eradicate all karma from each of us here. So returning to the purity. So all participants to the ceremony today would receive blessings. But those who are not here, but only watching through the internet, would receive 50% of the blessings. But those who are not here, and also are not watching over the webcast, will receive 0 blessings. So, did the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas hear that? Okay, let me ask. They said that the success would be 80%. Success and 20% because of the heavy karma, you cannot be completely purified for 20%. Of course, a lot of things can't be 100%. Like the spirits to be reborn into the Buddha lands, of course, cannot be 100%. That's your merit dedication, hoping that all Buddha spirits be reborn in the Pure Land. But there's some with heavy karma and some they are unwilling to go there. It would be impossible to send them over there. That's the problem. But this deity is already extremely great. It is the greatest, the first and foremost. Mahottara, Heruka, and Adibuddha, they are both the first and foremost. And the mudra is like this, very special, extraordinary. And at the top, there's a circle and a dot. And then below, it's like a mountain, like this. And his original meaning is that all sentient beings are Buddha natures. They are all Buddhas. It's just that when they descend, they disperse and they come down like a net. And in their spiritual cultivation, like the net, they return to the origin, of the Buddha nature, So today, we are like the net, like the great illusion, which is the greatest illusion, a kind of illusion. And then, from this dispersed net, we want to return to the original point. So, this is the key, the key point of the practices of Mahottara and Adibuddha. So, from all the great illusion returning to the original point, and then originally from the point becoming dispersed into the net. So that's the key point. And this is the mudra of Mahottara, the only mudra, and the mantra.
Om Pitta Sota Maha Siddhi Haruka Om Pe. 这是他本身的咒语。那么他的形象,
and his look, his appearance, this is Mahottara, very small.
这是他的观想,
his visualization is this. The mirrors in their hands would show all the Buddhas and the 100 serene and breathful deities inside their mirrors, his mirrors. This is a great Dharma. And the Muni, the benevolent one, of the Sakya, and what does it mean? So the able one of the Sakyamuni Buddha. So when we recite Sakyamuni's Buddha's mantra, this is the mantra of Sakyamuni Buddha, and Muni means the benevolent one, that the one able to perform, to bestow compassion in the Saha world. That's called the benevolent one, the greatest benevolent one, the benevolent of the Sakya clan. That's the mantra of Sakyamuni Buddha. That's the meaning. And his origin, of course, is the most supreme. And Mahottara Heruka was manifested by Adi Buddha. And his Vajra epithet, the Vajra name, is see-through Vajra, or Vajra of all eyes, eyes all over his body. There was a Dharma that with an eye at the top of the head and all the way to the anus. Of course, there's a hole in anus. And the eye on top of the head is not eminent. And then if it's open, there's an eye there, and then there's an eye at the anus, and they're reflecting each other. And then two eyes here, and then two ears, like two eyes in pairs, and ears and mouth, and all over the body are eyes in opposites. And ultimately, when all the eyes radiate lights, your whole body is light, and each skin pore is an eye. And ultimately, in your spiritual cultivation, in your internal organs and your bones, skin, flesh, bones, and all the internal organs, they all become light, transformed to become light. Only this would be called an attainment of fruition. At this time, when you transform to become light, that your whole body transformed to become rainbow light, there is nothing left in this world, not even the sarīras. They all transform to become light, all parts of your body. All that's left, but if you leave hair and nails, and the rest transform to become light, then they would be called the rainbow light transformation. That everything becomes rainbow light when at that time you don't leave behind anything. But if you leave behind some things like some sariras or sarira flowers, that's secondary. And you have whole body sarira, that's of the higher rank, that your whole body is a sarira. Or you cannot destroy the body, you become the physical body bodhisattva or physical body sarira. That's also very high rank. So of our disciples, Lianhua Yimin was a monk, but after he passed away, he became Master Lianhua Yimin.
That's
that he had a whole body sarira. Sariras all over his body. Really incredible. That you would have a big bag of sariras. Some people say that sariras are like kidney stones or gallbladder stones or bladder stones. That if you have the stones, that in the future those would become sariras. But interestingly, when my father was alive, he had kidney stones and stones in his blood, gallbladder or bladder. And he had them taken out, and then they came out, they came again, and he had those stones again. So kidney stones and bladder stones, that maybe it would be genetic, but Amitabha, I don't have any until now. So through Buddha's compassions, Bodhisattva's compassion, my dad never paid homage to the altar. And one day, my mom saw my dad crawling only in his underpants. And he crawled from his bed to the shrine and was lamenting because he was suffering pain from the stone, from the kidney stone. So he could bend the iron rod because he was in such great pain. And before, my dad never paid homage to the altar. Only that time he crawled to the front of the altar because he was suffering from great pain. And imagine how painful it was that he did that. So those stones were really horrible. But I think you can also destroy those stones in cremation, and then or using laser treatment that you can break them. But the true sariras cannot be break, cannot be broken. I experimented with it, that I place it on a cement floor, and I use a very heavy hammer to break it. And but instead, the fracture was on the cement, and the sarira got into the cement on an asphalt, that it would make a dent, and the sarira was still unblemished, because that's an essence. So today we talk about Mahottara, which is the great, the Vajra of the great illusion net, the great net of illusion. So what it means is that this world is the world with the things, tangible things, like the mountains, rivers, and the earth, and houses, cars, everything. That's the concrete world. And then the living beings, which is people, human beings, animals, plants, flying animals, the fishing, the fish, the swimming animals, those are called the living beings. So the animate and inanimate objects are all illusory. There's no real true to it, a real reality to it. So Huan is illusion or illusory. So I would like to transmit this Dharma practice, which is the illusory light Dharma. So you need to place a mirror on your altar, on your clean altar, pure altar. And then you sit in front of the mirror, observing yourself. And then above the mirror, you place an image of your deity. So you place a Buddhist image of your yidam or deity, say Vajrasattva. And one of his hands is holding a Vajra scepter, the other hand holding a Vajra bell, the yidam, the main deity. So holding like this. One Vajra scepter, the other one Vajra bell. His portrait or an image hang above the mirror. Vajrasattva or Vajradhara. And then select an image that's about the same as your size above the mirror, and then below it the mirror, and you look into the mirror every day, and you would discover that you would change every day. Carefully observe yourself in the mirror, your face. Look into the mirror, look at your own eyes, nose, mouth, ears, your shape, your look, and then take a look the following day, and every day you would change. But aren't we the same? How come not the same? But actually, not the same. You know that Grandmaster at 71 still have an acne. That's in Chinese, it's called like the youthful sign. So I keep this acne. Because this is a sign of my youth. When I was young, I had lots of acne before my marriage. On my wedding day, I had lots of acne on my face. I used three methods to eliminate the acne. The one is to starve myself, to starve the acne from nutrition, and I never eat. I didn't eat. But the acne didn't disappear. They're still all over my face, and they got even more. And then the second method is to wipe ointment on it to see if it's effective. I use all of them. And then the second day when I washed my face, they were still there. So all those acne treatments, ointments were fraud, fake. And then finally, you know what I use? I use like a razor and then it's just slide them off, slice them off. That's how I hate it, because they made me ugly. One of them, I scraped them from my face. But they came out again. It wasn't cured. And finally, I use fire to burn them. So I'll just burn them. But please don't imitate me. It was really hot. And then I just did it for a very short time. And then use a vapor, place some herbs inside the water, boiling water, and then use the vapor on my face. So I've used all different methods, but none of them work. But they got well. It got well after my marriage. They got well by itself. The acne disappeared by themselves. So those were all illusory. Now, to have one, even to have one, it's really difficult to have acne when you're 71. But now, I got one, so I want to maintain, to keep it on my face. And there's a slight pain on it. So I keep it to show that I'm still young. Even at 71, I still have this acne. In Chinese, it's like a bean of youth. So if you're in a good mood, what you see is like a smiling face. And then if you're sad, then you would have a sad face. So based on your mood, your face is different. Joy, anger, sad, happy. All there. All emotions would appear in the mirror. They're all your own manifestations. That's because your mind or heart is not stable. And then your eyes look at the Yidam, the deity. And if your main deity is Vajrasattva, look at his brows, his nose, his ears, his mouth, the facial features, his whole body, the beautiful, dignified look. And you also hold the Vajra scepter. And every day you look at the deity, look at the mirror, look at yourself, day after day after day. And then eventually, when you look into the mirror, all of a sudden, there's a Vajrasattva there. So this Vajrasattva is also an illusion that you create, because you look at Vajrasattva every day, and eventually when you look at yourself as Vajrasattva, and this is called attainment or fruition, success. In this illusory visualization. So when you look at Vajrasattva, and you also the same with Vajrasattva, you hold a Vajra scepter and Vajra bell. And you also wear a crown the same as Vajrasattva, wearing outfit the same as Vajrasattva. And then, you know, after gazing at this for a long period of time, then you become Vajrasattva. At this time, you and the you inside the mirror and the wisdom deity in the space and the image, the three of them would be in union. And then you would have attainment through this practice. And this is called the illusory visualization dharma. At this time, you become Vajrasattva, you recite his mantra, you look like him, so your eyes open and look at Vajrasattva, and there's Vajrasattva inside your heart, and your body also becomes Vajrasattva. And the you inside the mirror is illusory, but the you outside the mirror is also illusory. And then the wisdom deity Vajrasattva are also illusory. And these three illusories in union, then you would enter into the then you can enter into the deity Vajrasattva. So someone prayed that I want to feel how to be courted by someone. So and God told them that, oh, this is play of words in Chinese, that you can try not paying when you buy something. So, if you want to become Vajrasattva, you want to become your deity, you use this practice. And this is also called the like observing the illusions, Dharma practice, or also the mirror practice. So you sit in front of the mirror, meditating. So the you outside the mirror, the you inside the mirror, and the deity, and they're all of the same shape and size, and the three of this. So the you outside the mirror, you inside the mirror, and your original yidam, the three in union, then you are determined to go to that deity's pure land. This is a kind of Dharma practice or a spiritual cultivation. This is a joke.
This is a joke. 问总统为什么有差别待遇，学校你就装电风扇，监狱里面你就装冷气。总统就回答：“你认为我卸任以后还有机会回去念小学吗？”
So the president of Taiwan asked his ministers to install air conditioning in the prisons, but no aircon, but a fan in schools. And he was asked why, because he said, well, after I came down from presidency, it's impossible for me to return to schools, but it may be possible that I would be in prison. So wherever you will go in the future, you want to prepare yourself to look or to become like the main deity. So if you are mindful of the deity and you always think of the deity and you recite the deity's mantra and you form the deity's mudra and you enter into the deity's samadhi, then this observing the illusion Dharma practice or the mirror practice, then you would see yourself and you see the deity. So first you look from the outer, and then you are in union with the yidam, with the deity, and then you become the deity. That means you have the yogic response with the deity, and that's a tantric spiritual cultivation. So you're mindful of the deity, you form the deity's mudra, and you recite the deity's mantra, and then you become the deity. And in the mirror practice, it's the same. You often look at the deity, and you look at yourself in the mirror, and you look at the you outside the mirror, and that's the same as the you in the mirror that's changing every day. So, but the you inside the mirror is gradually transformed to become the deity until that the you inside the mirror merges with the you outside the mirror and the deity in the space, then that would be called a spiritual response or yogic response. So this kind of Dharma practice is extremely good. So a beautiful girl in fashion told the shopkeeper, "I want all these clothes." And the shopkeeper was wrapping them up, and then the lady, the beautiful lady, cried out. And the shopkeeper asked, "I forgot to bring money." And the beautiful lady was embarrassed and said, "Oh, I forgot to bring my boyfriend." So in order to have success, you need to bring along your yidam, your deity, then you would succeed. Then you would have attainments. You cannot forget your main deity, then that's not spiritual cultivation. You should be mindful of your deity. You always bring along your deity, then that's spiritual cultivation. So, men are different from women. So, washing face is just using water for Grandmaster. I never put on any makeup. And no sunscreen or sunblocks, no cosmetics, just washing clean, wash, that's good enough. But for women, they can change. Sometimes they look really pale and cold, almost look like a hang, like a ghost that hang, that was dead, hang. But in a moment, in a few minutes, they became a beautiful lady with the red lips and blushes, and then with the eyeliners and brows, and with the fake eyelashes, they became beautiful. And when they took them all off, they became like a ghost. Like a ghost that hang dead. What a huge difference. Because everything is illusory, everything's just an illusion. So they can change. But for men, men don't wear lipsticks. Xiaoqiao, Louis, doctor. He's a surgeon now. Now he knows that he becomes a plastic surgeon. And I asked him, "Is that right?" "Yes." "Okay, give me your name card. Because one day, maybe he's in California now, in Sacramento, the place for the Sakya Temple, Sakya Leizang Temple there. He opened a plastic surgery clinic there. And he said he would prepare the equipments anytime you call me. I want to lengthen my ears. And he said, no problem. With two injections, then your ears would droop. Then I would look like Amitabha.
Namo Amitabha. Namo Amitabha. Namo Amitabha. This小乔听众啊，你要把我整成阿弥陀佛啊！ 把我整成阿弥陀佛，眼睛变大一点，还有眼睛变亮一点，亮一点，啊，鼻子应该有够挺的吧，可以的。你看着阿弥陀佛的嘴巴，把它整好一点，还有给它加一点这个红，啊，做成粉红的，再贴一点腮红。 营养好一点，还有面孔圆一点，面孔把它整圆一点。我一出来，人家看到我，哇，阿弥陀佛！<笑><笑>这个就是像，因为我们人生也是幻嘛，对不对？ 我拿年轻的照片给你看，你也认不得我。我戴学士帽的时候啊，那时候测量学校大学部毕业的时候，我是公学士，然后戴着学士帽出来，那时候瘦瘦的脸，啊，看，跟现在不一样。但是我中年的时候啊，我也很英俊潇洒。 很美的，那时候留着头发，我年轻的时候有一张照片非常的好看，非常好看，我自己都很欣赏我自己，<笑>看着说哇，这么潇洒，难怪那时候女朋友一大堆，<笑>人生都是幻觉嘛，你看。 年轻的时候这个像，中年的时候是一个像，年纪大了又是一个像，什么时候是一样的像啊？不可能一样的，这就是大幻。你知道那个谢明芳师姐吗？谢明芳师姐在那里，你知道她以前开那个小西贡（ （Little Saigon） 的那个 restaurant， 在加拿大 Little Saigon restaurant。 那时候他穿着一条热裤，我记得印象很深。我车子开过去，他穿一条热裤，哇，穿个那个花的衬衫，穿一条热裤，青春洋溢啊！哇，那时候看了，哦，好美哦。啊，这时候就不用讲了。<笑>谢明芳很美的。 你不晓得，我们曾经跳过舞，然后我跟他一起，我那时候还没有出家了，还没有出家，我跟他跳过一支舞，跳了一半，啊，我就要回去了。我说啊，一半留着下一次跳吧。现在一直到现在都没有跳。在公车上人很多，你没有座位怎么办？叫醒一个正在熟睡的人。 跟他讲说，你到站了，然后他会谢谢你，然后就赶快飞奔的下去。这一招真的很好用。不要问我怎么知道这个方法的，因为啊，那一天他也是被人家这样子叫下车。<笑> 很佛法有很多的方法都可以回到原点大幻都可以回到很多的原点你要学习种种的佛法你都一样可以回到原点不一定只有一个法所以叫法无定法没有一定的方法你可以回到原点但是只要让你能够回到原点的法就是佛法所以你修住净法你一样可以回到原点变成本尊那你修任何个法都可以修着火法修明点法啊，修这个牵示法修牵示法说修这中阴闻教得度的法修光明法修光明法、哦、然后修这个梦观法刚刚我的是梦观法、哎、刚刚我的是幻观法还有修梦观法、哦、这个六成就法在十轮金刚里面强调六成就法大梵法王金刚里面也强调六成就法白教的那洛六法也是六成就法十轮金刚法里面一样有六成就法六成就法任何一个法都可以回到原点大手印法大圆满法、哦、另外大圆盛会道果法另外还有大威德法都可以回到原点的他们啊彼此之间都是有共同的只要从幻回到真实的佛性那就是修行
So it's always off? As long as you do the practice then you would return to the origin
It was off、
hmm? No problem? So, let me repeat. So, any Buddha Dharma that allow you to return to the origin, any methods that allow you to return to the origins are called Buddha Dharma, and they are not just one fixed way to return to the origin, but there are many methods, many ways that can make you return to the origin.
别忘了把牛奶放回冰箱里，把蜂蜜
放回
橱柜里面。如果把炉子或皮都弄脏了，可要擦干净了，知道了吗？还有点点点点点。这个时候丈夫就讲说：“算了吧，我现在有点困。”
This is a joke.
我们生活中的法。
So true Buddha school Dharma is the simplest, the most brief, simplest and powerful, and they are quintessentials. It's the essence, the quintessentials. So,And all the mantras are always the shortest. They are the essence, the quintessence. All that I told you, that I taught, are all the quintessence. If you just put them into practice, that's it. So in the four traditional dharma, it's the Kriya Yoga, the Karma Yoga, Tantra Yoga, and the highest Tantra Yoga.So the Karma Yoga are very, very mundane and details, very detailed and very lengthy that you may fall asleep listening to those. But listening to Grandmaster's teaching, you would never fall asleep. Simple, very clear and to the point.If you listen to a master talking, they're like continual, lengthy, and 5 and 6 hours, and you start wiggling around, and they're still talking and talking. And he talked from 10 till 3 a.m. and still talking, still talking. And everybody else falling asleep. But Grandmaster's tantric dharma are the most essential, the simplest, and to the point. This is a joke. A man divorces his wife and wants to marry a mistress, but is afraid to harm the 3-year-old daughter, so he told the daughter, "Your mom is aged and not beautiful, so can I get you a beautiful mom?" And the daughter said, "No way. How about your mom? Your mom is even older. Can we change her, Grandma?" But the Buddha Dharma that Grandmaster teaches is the simplest and smartest Dharma. If you want to change your spiritual centers, go ahead. But this is the simplest, easiest, and then the briefest and smartest Dharma. And you don't want this, and you want to learn something more, something worse. Go ahead, Om Mani Padme Hum. Yeah.